But the thing is, this system, the renewing of the system of the beast or of Babylon, is in progress. It is now reforming in preparation for it being the mold or the model to bring in the Antichrist and, you know, the ushering forth of the tribulations and all that towards going towards the day of the Lord or the day of Yahweh. The future Antichrist figure who will head up such a collective system is prophesied to proclaim himself to be God, actually be God, in the temple, okay? Which requires a temple, okay? Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that the man of sin be revealed, the man of sin being the Antichrist, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, all that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God. I'm sorry about all these gods and all that, the titles. I mean Yahweh, showing himself that he is God. Okay. This act in the future is the ushering forth, or is the abomination of desolation. Okay. And those previous verses were 2 Thessalonians 2, verses 3 through 4, King James. And this next verse is from Matthew 24:15. When ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, which is basically the Old Testament version of the apocalypse or the revelation, which it is, okay. When you see that abomination of desolation stand in the holy place, and then see also Mark 13:14. But when you see that spoken by Daniel, that is in Babylon of old, we had a system of idolatry in which rulers were worshipped as gods, okay, in the Babylon of old. But in the Babylon of the future, it will be the same. You see what I'm saying? Gods, prophets, pharaohs, all such things on earth, people have been worshiping men and even demigods and crossbreed Nephilim hybrids as gods all throughout history. Either. And it's going to go back to that. So it will be totally pagan. Okay. This future desolation event will simply be another reiteration or rerun, therefore, of past events, past beast systems, and all such things, based upon a common or collective system of ungodly thoughts and beliefs. Again, this dichotomy, you got the goats and the sheep, and we're separating more and more every day. Nothing new under the sun. See Ecclesiastes 1, verse 9. The thing that hath been and is that which shall be, and that which is done is what shall be done, and there is no new thing under the sun. Okay? There's no new thing. All right. Please understand this type of man-god worship, which I have been describing, was proclaimed and accepted in many or most of the empires of the past, including Rome, Egypt, and of course, in Babylon of old. So this isn't something new. They're all simply iterations of the same rulership principles, which has enslaved man throughout history since Yahweh was rejected and chose to follow men, and people chose to follow men or kings instead, going back to 1 Samuel 8 verse 7, King James. And Yahweh said unto Samuel, hearken unto the voice of the people in all they say unto thee, for they have not rejected thee, but they have rejected me. And this is Yahweh talking, the Most High, the Almighty. They men rejected him and wanted them that they should have a king to reign over them, okay? And that's what they got. And that's what we've been going through. That's what we've been enslaved by and murdered by and persecuted by ever since. Think about it. Those fools were warned at that time, and he was told to tell them, tell the people what this is going to end up being like. And if they agree, then give them a king, okay? And those fools were warned, but they allowed themselves to be bound by their choice and their rejection of the Most High, favoring servitude and bondage to these kings and so-called God kings. You know, I don't know what to say about that. I mean, you know, we're still paying for that blasphemous, you know, heresy and the faithlessness of our forefathers in the far distant past, okay? Anyway, a distinctive characteristic of beast systems, past, present, and future, is that they are of one mind and represent collective or shared sociocultural identity and or morality and so-called religion, as it may pertain to acceptance and or adherence to similar thoughts, beliefs, and deeds. That is, they think alike, they believe alike, and they act alike, okay? These nations, Revelation 17, verse 13, these nations have one mind and shall give their power and strength unto the beast. Okay, one mind. The scattering was the establishment, the scattering in Babylon, okay, was the establishment of the will of the Father, henceforth and forever until the end, to be the rule. For mankind to be separated into nations, okay? Therefore, nationalism is by decree of the Most High, and he wanted to keep things separate for a good reason. Why? Because the people rebelled and thought they were going to take over heaven, basically. You know, reach up to heaven with the tower and then fight against Most High, which is ridiculous, you know. But they must have had some leadership telling them that they could be doing it, and they went an awful lot of trouble to actually begin to do so before they gave it up when they were scattered and their language was confused. Okay, so nationalism, or the nationalist trend that we have today, is in support of the Father and his way, okay? It goes in opposition to the evils of the globalist or collective world government mind, and is being led and mediated by such men as President Trump and others throughout the world, you know, and it is becoming predominating, beginning to predominate and to surface. Those and those of a similar mind of a nationalist attitude, which is pro the Almighty, pro Yahweh, as in, you know, like Brexit and in the UK and other places. Okay, there's a lot of this nationalist trending right now, nationalism. Knowingly or not, these nationalist leaders at this time are supporting the will of the Most High. Understand and support these people and their ideas, because it goes against the collectivist one world nature of the Babylonian renewal. Okay, there's a time for evil to fully engulf the nation. This is granted, and it will happen as it has been prophesied to occur. But I suggest that it is not, this time is not yet come for that to happen. And as I stated a couple years ago, I believe we have a temporary retreat, a reprieve, for us to repent as people and as nations, and to be healed and to return to prosperity and all that, if we repent of our ways, such as this bizarre promotion of homosexuality and gender fluidity and killing babies. That ain't gonna cut it, you know. There has to be a turning away from that, and a repentance, and asking forgiveness, and then true change will occur, okay? As it was given to Nineveh, okay? Nineveh, you know, the story of, you know, Jonah and the whale and all that. Well, he was on a journey, okay, to Nineveh to give them a message, and then eventually Nineveh did repent and go the other way and became godly and did not come under condemnation. There is that example of averting disaster and judgment was not put into the scriptures by accident. Okay, it's for someone to learn from. Alright, and I hope that you and I can see things in a scriptural way as it was meant to be. Okay, and I'm not saying God has, or Yahweh has blessed President Trump or the world or anything else to, related to that, but anyway, what is needed is repentance, okay, and a turning around. And yeah, there should be, you know, and I've been talking about, you know, the goats and the sheep and all that, and this dichotomy of bizarre leftist insane thinking and traditional or conservative thought, and how far they are being separated. But there should be a separation, and it is just like being separated good from evil. And it's always how it has been, you know, so understand. It is becoming clearly evident at this time that the globalist Babylon and her lovers have the goal of reforming her and preparing to rule their rule for all the nations. They want to rule all the nations from a central, you know, unelected, what would you call it? Authoritarian position of some kind, dictatorship, or, you know, collective. But it's a collective of Babel, and we must resist being led back into the bondage of the collectivist. Okay. Now, in the predictive programming that we're all constantly under, one might envision this beast system as a Borg-like collective. Although, you know, if you know what the Borg are from Star Trek Next Generation, I believe, if you're not familiar with that, it's a collective mentality, but they swallow up worlds instead of nations, okay? And, you know, and I've got a lot of videos, and in my playlist I have a lot of videos that have to do with different types of deceptions by these Borg-like collectivists. And I have a list here of a few of these things. I'll just take a picture of it here and hopefully I get it, put it in the video, because I'm not sure how this is all going to be put together. But go see them, look them up. A lot of those have to do with deceptions of, you know, the end of the world scripting, the various scripts that they might or probably will use, such as aliens and, you know, their Antichrist system, the global agendas, Iron Mountain, for example, and the arrival type of mentality and discussions that are everywhere, yeah. anyway. Bear in mind that being of one mind, though, in and of itself, is not evil. And it is a characteristic and it is the beliefs that separate us one from another of these groups. We are also to be of one mind as well, forming the dichotomy of these two opposing groups to which I refer. Anyway, the one be of the few on the right hand side, the sheep, and one being of the many of the left hand side, or the goats. Okay. We should strive to become the remnant who come out of her, being separate from her and in opposition to those of the world. And now I've gone through and collected what I believe to be relevant scriptural verses having to do with, for one thing, the few and or the remnant and being of one mind. And I'll probably put in a little a graphic or a media presentation of some kind that shows these. I don't know. I also put together quite a few on how being separate is the goal. You know, 2 Corinthians 6:17, be separate, says Yahweh, do not touch what is unclean. Matthew 13:49, separate the wicked from among the just. Matthew 25:32, all nations will be gathered before him and he will separate them one from another, as coincidentally, a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And that we are not to love we are not to love, sorry about that, the ways, thoughts, beliefs, and deeds of the world, and to come out of her. Okay, so we are to be separate, we are to come out of her, and her is Babylon. Okay, Babylon the Great has fallen, has fallen, has become the habitation of devils. Revelation 18:2-3. See those. There's her sins have reached unto heaven, and God hath remembered her iniquities. And the kings of the earth who have committed fornication and lived deliciously with her shall bewail her and lament for her, and so on and so on. And the merchants of the earth shall weep and mourn over her, for no man buyeth their merchandise. Okay. Anyway, the separation described and or the dichotomy that I have described throughout is what we should now be seeing clearly. It is becoming fact, and it is becoming clearly a fact. The lines of battle are being drawn in the sand, and there are examples and clear examples of right versus wrong, good versus evil, that present us with an opportunity to profess and uphold the way of the Father and his system of laws and his morality, which is instructed within the scriptures. The lines have been crossed by the enemy. Do you recognize the breaches? And if you don't, then I wonder what salve one might need to open your eyes. Most salient are things blatantly wrong, patently and blatantly wrong, like abortion and the slow abolition of all things Christian, the censorship of Christian morality and or what you one might call conservative or right wing, even. Although I don't like to get it into the political realm, but they have banned prayer in schools, yet all of a sudden they are bowing over and bending over to the Muslims and allowing and setting forth prayer times and prayer places for them. Does that make sense to you? Does it seem fair or just, or is it just anti-Christian? Is it okay to be have a religion as long as it's not Christian? And apparently that is the truth. Anyway, advancing and sanctioning pedophilia, homosexuality, and or trans whatever, and teaching this insane gender confusion to our children is another biggie. Okay, that's not a minor thing. You know, they are indoctrinating your children that there is no such thing as men and women. This is one of the basic bases of you know, living in a world that is made and created the way it was to be made by the Most High. You know, basic laws of Yahuwah. And these are and creation, and you know, evolution is another one of those big issues, which is, you know, now just accepted as being fact. It isn't fact. In fact, more and more data and more cogent supports for a non-evolutionary standpoint are scientifically validated. You know. I'm not anti-science. I'm not, because I'm not anti-truth, and I'm not anti-observation and fact and truth. They go against their own boundaries when they attest or profess that such things are fact, because they're not, and there is no proof. Anyway, I don't want to go on and on about that. But all these things go against the laws of Yahuwah. And break down the pillars of the ways in which he formed our families, our nations, and our personal and national sovereignty, you know. And see my playlist of videos, for example, on the three pillar series and stuff like that. Anyway, and they use social programming and politically correct, or PC, along with training. With training and propaganda by slow successive approximations and habituation, pounding their message and their narratives in order to slowly but surely establish their thoughts and belief within our forehead, therefore leading to them. Altering or changing that which we would find to do with our hands, deeds, and these thoughts and beliefs lead to deeds. Anyway, or they may lead us to accept or ignore their infractions as being normal. Okay, so normative modeling is also part of that, and their evil deeds are then accepted as okay. You know, now it's like, oh well, that's okay, they can do whatever they want to, you know. We must wake up to recognize and then act to undo. There is a repentance that needs to go on. We need to undo the evil that they have done to us and keep it from spreading further to our children and further generations down the road. Okay. Remember the White House being put up with the rainbow when they were celebrating the homosexuality, the marriage of homosexuals being supported by the Supreme Court. It wasn't law. It was never put into law. It was just figment. Okay. Anyway, it was celebrated, and it was celebrated by the homosexual in the White House itself. So, whatever. But if we do not face these evils, then we face judgment for them and accepting them, accepting their views and their deeds and their thoughts. Okay. their goal is to enslave us mentally and or physically under the same pagan and satanic systems of belief and government that was prevalent in Babylon, worshiping their gods and their kings and their popes or their church-state rule, which will be that everyone is okay, there's Unitarian or ecumenical thought that everything is okay and that, you know, do as thou wilt, okay? And they will become the rulers once again if they spread their Babylonian ideals to us, okay, or if we put up with it. Alright, think about it. Many ways and many timely topics come under this heading of Babylon and the renewal of it, including the migrant issues and the overall call to tear down the walls of nationality and nationalism. This is blatantly a measure to bring back Babylon, okay? Those who support such insane propositions as open borders and the socialist degeneration of the world are traitors to both man and Yahuwah, and therefore it is clear that they are evil, okay? These and other socialist propositions and these strange mentalities and bizarre anti-Yahuwah thoughts like open borders and the mixing and melding of all the peoples back into a single system is or goes against the Most High and his wishes and his scattering, which he did purposefully, okay. You know, one follower, the systems of law and governance set up in Western nations follow and support his natural Yah-given rights and laws of the land and provide a basis for us receiving the blessings that we now and still have, though maybe perhaps not long. Not for long, but we have been granted that by the Most High because we have, in general, supported his way and his morality and his separation, okay? They want to give it all up and be PC and part of the in-group, then, you know, get prepared for destruction and judgment, okay? And they ain't gonna be pretty, you know. And this is the crux of the meaning that I think I was led to put forth in this video. That if you're gonna go along with it, if you're gonna allow them to do it, then it's by choice. And you will be judged and there will be destruction going on. If we are not awakened or we fail to act, there are evil people posing as good who will lead us captive by their insidious evil thoughts and deeds, leading to perilous times led by reprobates who resist and deny the truth and the way of the Most High. This is blatant and it is obvious to me at any point. They will, under the guise of doing good things and thinking themselves righteous, lead us into Babylon once more, and they will take over the nations, substituting their evil system of globalist intent and proportions, ushering in the beast and the Antichrist. Okay, the beast is here. The systems of the beast are here. They're operating right now. They're just waiting for a leader. They need us to accept their evil as good. And in Isaiah 5, verse 20, King James, it says, "Woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness, and put bitter for sweet or sweet for bitter." That's 2 Colossians 11, verses 14 and 15. "And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. Okay. And their works are evil, and their thoughts are evil, and all such things. At any rate, the evil ones, the minions, or the followers of Satan and the Babylonian worldly realm or systems, they want to tear down the most basic units of order of the family and the very pillars of man and or the separated nations. They want Babylon to return. This desire to renew and implement systems of human governance in a church-like and pagan ruling system, or satanic, and or satanic. This system of human governance originated in Babylon, and it is becoming more and more clear daily that anyone seeking truth beyond so-called mainstream news and information and their disinformation worldwide has to seek some other way to find truth. Okay. Lies and false narratives abound in nearly every facet of information and disinformation worldwide, which goes back to, you know, many of my videos, especially, you know, mass media machinations and all that.
It's 1 o'clock.
Pretty much throughout my videos you'll be seeing a lot of things relating to that, okay. But anyone seeking truth beyond this, you have to go beyond the mainstream media and all such things. The topics of concern are all related to the disruption and dissolution of religion as we know it or knew it, national sovereignty, and the family. These are the three pillars of man, as I have, you know, suggested. All such narratives promote thoughts, beliefs, and behaviors that go against the law of the Most High and His will and His desire and His separation of mankind into nations and into discrete and separated partitioning zones. Okay. And these include behaviors, that which is patently abominable and ungodly, things like gender confusion, abortion, homosexuality, universalist churches, ecumenical unite movement, or Unitarian movements, promoted by the Roman Catholic Church state, and other globalist plots, okay. You know, they want governance by some nebulous, remote group of unelected officials that we, or one might call, a one-world government, you know. Of course, all these narratives are promulgated under the guise, again, of being good or fair or as social justice, and proving how upright and, you know, what do they call that, signaling, I forget, anyway, showing that there's loving and tolerant towards those who think or act supposedly differently. But what it's telling though is that how intolerant such people are to anything that goes against their own beliefs and or their own narrative. And then they become violent, and, you know, that's like the supposed Antifa movement, which is anti-First Amendment, really. So we need to keep these people at bay, and we need to defeat them and all of their ideas if we are to even go on with any kind of normality or procession of our traditional beliefs and values and all such things, okay? And they're going to say, and they're going to pretend to be good and tolerant and all that, but they are liars, okay? Yeah. And they want to bring back the enslavement and the binding that they've had, as in Babylon, where they got everyone to act in one with one mind against the Most High, because they need to recruit mercenaries and people to do their bidding. Okay, other bizarre ideas and false narratives include global warming, climate change, you know, the intrusion of an environmentalist or Gaiaistic viewpoint or worship, is really what it is paganism, and they use that as a reason to show that they're justice warriors and they're good and they're all that. But really what it's all about is they want to rob you and then destroy you through your stupidity. Current state of affairs is that evildoers and their corporate media mouthpieces want to silence all opposing views, which is in this day and age is censoring, massive censoring, deplatforming, and or using algorithms to reduce or eliminate contrary voices and opinions. All opposing views and or everyone with a scriptural basis for morality or a sense of true justice, and those who do understand what is good and what is right, are what they just can't tolerate. Okay, keep in mind scriptures clearly state such wrong thinking and this backwards or even bizarre turning around of narratives begets woe. Woe unto them to call evil good and good evil, etc., etc. Thankfully, there are individuals and groups who manage to create and maintain a media presence and to promulgate truth and a clear vision of reality as seen by individuals and groups in opposition to the massive lies and propaganda and narratives that are in the foreground at this time. Assuming that people come to view my videos for truth, and I hope so, I must admonish all viewers to more actively support all the purveyors of truth and alternative resources and or media out there in the internet and elsewhere that we rely upon, we must rely upon. We must support and establish rule of law, lest we fall back into lawlessness, in which case they will take over. These passages that in the scriptures provided at the beginning end with the source of boundaries and law for law and instruction that can be relied upon to determine that which is good and righteous in both belief and practice, insofar as our Creator is concerned, and that is the Scripture. Okay, and refer to some of my previous videos in which these truths are intimated, and that the New Testament serves as both a buttressing and even expanding understanding of the very same basic laws of Yahuwah stated in the Old Testament. And I'll say old. Do not be deceived by those who eschew or support lawlessness or that the perfect law was changed in error. This is a lie. Based upon scriptures, one can see that having awareness and following his law, one shall be thoroughly furnished for unto all good works. Okay, this can be likened to the hope that those who think and believe truth and the rule of law, which is set forth in scriptures, will hopefully lead to action which is sanctified by the Most High. That such prescribed action includes opposing, exposing, and rebuking that which is ungodly and those people and their attributes that we currently face. Because things are getting worse and worse progressively. Get it? We must all play a part. Also remember that the adversaries see themselves as somehow purveyors of goodliness or godliness, and they claim to be righteous and, you know, warriors for social justice and stuff like that. They are deceived, remember, and they think that they are the ones in the right and that you are the evil ones. A dichotomy, just like I explained. What will you do given these things that I have gone through? And what can you do to address the apparent overthrow by these deceivers who wish to reintroduce and renew the lawlessness of paganism and of Babylon? We were told that we must come out of her, based, you know, on more than one occasion, one of those being Revelation 18:4, I heard another voice from heaven saying, "Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues." Okay, that is the judgment that is coming. Do you want to receive her plagues? I don't. You know. Well, there's a choice there. So, anyway, I'm going to wrap this up, and hopefully you've gained some kind of insight or a greater understanding or a desire to look it up even more. And I encourage that. You know, don't just accept anything that I've said. Look it up, be a Berean, and think about it. I'm just framing some of the information so it can be consumed perhaps in a different viewpoint, or maybe it supports what you already think. Either way, may all who view, listen, or read this content be blessed with a greater or expanding understanding and a desire to pitch in and help avert the renewal of Babylon and the evil ones who profess righteousness yet are unlawful. And so be it.